having a tag like the Jacobus Fellowship is something that really helps her get recognition outside of the Princeton community so that she can really achieve her goals over her career.
My name is Neereja Sundaresan. I am a graduate student in the Electrical Engineering Department, and my research is using superconducting circuits to study many-body quantum optics.
Neereja is an exceptional student. Everybody in lab calls her rabbit foot. She just seems to get experiments to work that seem really challenging and difficult. And so, I mean, I feel like I've known her since she was a sophomore in college. She came and worked in my lab over the summer. And even in 8 weeks as a summer intern, as a sophomore, you could give her a problem and she would come back with really nice solutions that worked really well. Since she started as a graduate student, you know, every experiment she's been given, she just keeps plugging away and gets things that seem difficult, challenging, impossible to work.
So we take a piece of sapphire, which looks very clear, and we take it into the clean room and we deposit on top of it a very thin layer of niobium. And so when it goes down inside our fridge to 10 millikelvin or below its critical temperature, it actually superconducts. So there's no loss. So you can imagine that if you have a very, very long wire, just any wire that you might see in this room, and you send in a very weak signal, that wire itself is lossy. So by the time you get to the end, it's probably gone and you're just having a bunch of noise. But if this is superconducting, whatever you put in the beginning will be there at the end. So you can think of it as not having any loss. And so what this means is that you can design different types of circuits where loss is very, very controlled.
A really excellent student is one who can start off in a direction but keep their eyes open and really keep thinking about what's going on and figure out when is it more fruitful to change direction, when is it more fruitful to do this instead of that.
We understand a lot of things about light, and we understand a lot of things about photons, but we don't understand everything. There's a lot out there that people just don't understand yet. It's something that will come in the future, I have no doubt, but it's by doing experiments and doing careful theoretical analysis that we understand how photons behave in different environments. Understanding them and how they behave and getting them into behave the way you want to is a really exciting area of science. And so
that's what I'm interested in.